Public Enemy and Devo got in a rumble in a back alleyway, you'd come out with two Skinnee J's.
Special J, Jay Guevara, Stevie Spice, that's me, Eddie Eyeball, Andy Action. And then we did some market research and we found out that this type of look is not actually very successful these days.
And pretty much the Sugar Ray EVERLAST tour and the recording of Volumizer after it was the peak.
I wasn't there at the time. I had been fired 3 years prior. So.
The very first tour that I ever did with the J's, I was like, I wonder what I'm gonna be wearing. So then I find out, and it's actually a pair of real, real tight white girl pants with pink flowers on each ass cheek.
That was kind of my only card at the time. I can be like, hi, I'm rich. Hi, I'm famous. No, the only thing I had going for me was in the band.
This is to distract you from how old we are.
It's like vacation, you know? Like I can already feel like it's gonna be over a week from tomorrow. So I'm already feeling depressed about it.
Is she thinking of you?
Nah, she just thought she knew.
But she's looking at you.
Nah, man, she's looking through.
And now I realize I got no shape or size to the girl with the world in her eyes. So I keep bouncing.
Cruise America, for those who like cruise.
You get free complimentary toilet paper with your $5,000 rental purchase. It's the poop packet.
We've destroyed so many of these RVs.
Oh man, I've been driven one of these things in a
long time.
Everyone for themselves.
That's the spirit. Now we're on tour.
Tell you what, these two Skinnee J's have been with me from my formative years when I really learned what music was, and they've been with me and they're still with me. And I'll tell you what, if they came back and did this tomorrow night, I'd be here rocking out.
It's been probably 9 years, and I've probably seen them 30 times.
I've been a fan for 11 years.
This band has shaped how I define literally my personal identity.
I've been waiting for this for a really long time.
And I realized that I was more awesome because of the two Skinnee J's.
There are definitely some serious, serious train wrecks.
Flat tire, car accident. He left the keyboard equipment in New York. What's our backup plan?
I don't know. There's no way we can do it. Stevie doesn't, all the shit's in there. Fucking the zip drives, the hard drive, everything. The fucking...
The show. Will we be playing a show tonight? Possible. Could happen.
Just so many things that are out of your control. Like we did what we were supposed to, we thought.
It just got messy. Everything started getting messy.
And took some spoils with us along the way, and that's just the bottom line. That's what we did. It was a pirate ship.
We're like right about to go on stage, the house music's off and they're yelling like at the top of their lungs, and I know the kids in the front could like hear them.
You're not gonna just like swap out the front man because there's a conflict between the front man and the drummer.
I'm trying to count, I'm gonna try to go 1, 2, 3, 4, and I can't sing, you know, and I can't, so like when I start trying to talk and play, I'm just like, so I start fucking up, you know, I'm just like.
The sense of who I was just kind of collapsing. There were a lot of moments that I look back on and are embarrassing because there were literally like nights where it would end with tears.
Very complicated and pretty intense. You know, in great ways and in not so great ways.
It's gay retarded Yoda.